Assalamu alaikum. Welcome back to another Biostats ATP video. This time around, we'll be talking about the receiving operating characteristic curve, also known as the ROC curve. This curve helps us understand how well a test can distinguish between two groups. In other words, how well can the test see if the patient does or does not have the disease? The y-axis is the true positive rate, otherwise known as sensitivity. The x-axis is the false positive rate, otherwise known as the complement or the opposite of specificity, or 1 minus specificity, if you will. The curve is defined by its specificity, sensitivity, and associated cutoffs. In other words, how well it can identify those with the disease compared to those without a disease based on different cutoffs is what determines the ultimate shape of the curve. For instance, let's take a group of people we tested for condition X with a cutoff of 100 units. Suppose after all the calculations, we ended up with a sensitivity of 80% and specificity of 85%. However, what if we want to see what would happen to sensitivity and specificity if we raised or lowered the cutoff? For example, when we raised the cutoff by 20 units, the sensitivity dropped to 70% while specificity became 90%. What if we lowered the cutoff by 20 points? Then sensitivity became 90% and specificity dropped to 70%. I'm just making up the numbers here to keep it simple, but notice how we're getting sort of a nice curve here. If you rinse and repeat this with many different cutoffs, you'll get a curve that shows you what the sensitivity and specificity would look like based on the chosen cutoffs. This makes it easier to understand what cutoffs would be most helpful to apply in each situation without having to manually write down all the possible cutoffs and their associated sensitivity and specificity. Notice how the left lower corner suggests a sensitivity of 0% and a specificity of 100%. This would sort of be like raising the cutoff so high that you won't get any false positives. Still not really that practical, huh? On the other end of the spectrum, the top right corner suggests a sensitivity of 100% and a specificity of 0%. This would be like having a very low cutoff. Sure, you wouldn't get any false negatives, but this isn't all that practical either. The top left corner suggests a test with 100% sensitivity and 100% specificity. That is where we would ideally want every test to cross. Please note that sometimes the curve is not perfectly symmetrical. This is just a testament to how real life doesn't always provide you with the perfect curves, but beggars can't be choosers, huh? Moving on, how can we apply this concept? Well, sometimes a test is needed to screen or confirm diseases. If you are using a test as a screening tool, your job is to look for a test with the highest sensitivity. In other words, the highest point on the curve with an acceptable detriment to specificity. That is to say, we can't just take the highest point overall because that would leave us with a specificity that is very close to zero, and thus the test would have much, much less value. A good example of a high point that doesn't completely wipe specificity would be like this one, for example. But if it's a confirmatory test, you're looking for the leftmost point, so you would pick this point without completely wiping out sensitivity. So as you can see, the ROC curve is immensely useful in helping us visualize the different cutoffs of a test and allows us to make decisions as to which test or which cutoffs of a particular test would be better suited to being a more sensitive tool or specific tool. When it comes to comparing two different tests, eyeballing the ROC curves becomes very, very handy. Since the top left corner suggests an ideal test, we want curves to be closer to that corner. Another way you could go around this is to check which curve has more area under it. Every curve will start at the bottom left corner and end at the top right corner, so how much it approaches the top left corner will also determine how much area it covers under it. So for example, when looking at these two curves, it's clear that curve A is the better performing test since it covers a lot more area under it than curve B. With this paradigm in your mind, we'd like to add a few more concepts to help tie things together. Accuracy is an important term and relates to the validity of a measurement. I like to think of it as the trueness of a measurement to help remind me of the formula, which is true positive plus true negative over true positive plus true negative plus false negative. Pretty much everything goes in the denominator while only the true ones go into the numerator. A test is considered more accurate the closer it approaches the top left corner, and less accurate as it approaches the diagonal line. We'll be covering accuracy and its associated terms in more detail in a future video. We just wanted to mention a few points here to help tie in a few more concepts in relation to the ROC curve. Last but not least, since the ROC curve can reveal to us the sensitivity and specificity of a particular cutoff, we can actually find out the true positives, true negatives, false positives, and false negatives. However, we also need just a little bit more given. Specifically, we need the amount of people we are testing and how many of them have the disease, aka the prevalence. Using this given, we can actually find out the true positives, true negatives, false positives, and false negatives. Turns out the ROC curves can do a lot of cool things, huh? In summary, the ROC curve is built using two axes, sensitivity and 1 minus specificity, otherwise known as the false positive rate. It also allows you to choose the optimal cutoff for a test by looking at the ROC curve of that test. That way you can have an idea about the sensitivity and specificity of that particular cutoff. The curve also allows you to compare between different tests by calculating the area under curve, AUC, to determine which one is better. Lastly, remember this relationship. Sensitivity goes with screening a disease, while specificity is more about confirming the presence of the disease. With that, we hope you benefited from this video. Consider liking and subscribing, and as always, thanks for watching. Which is true positive plus true negative over true positive plus false positive plus true negative plus... All right, I got this.